Hi, my name is Dan Petrowski from AAG, and today we're going to take a look at abstract submission using the AAG abstract submission system. So we are looking at the demo screen for our abstract collection product. This is not a real client site. And a user would enter this page, and they would normally, if they're a new user, they would click on the register button and enter their basic contact information. But we're going to log in as a returning user, so that we can get a little quicker start and be able to see what it looks like to have a user that comes back in and enters a new abstract there. So we're presented with the welcome page. On this page there's instructions and reminders of basic guidelines and deadlines for the submissions. And we could go to My Submissions, or we have the choice of clicking on New Submission. These options are also available up at the top navigation. So we're going to click on New Submission and show you what it looks like to submit a brand new abstract. So we're given the title tab, and we just enter some title information, and we can at any time save and continue, move on to the next tab after we've entered the title. But I'm just going to show you a few options here of picking presenter type and the category, and then of course the main body of the abstract, which in this case is called Overview. And I'm going to just grab a bunch of text here and I'm going to paste it, fix my typos. And I'm going to paste it so that you can see the word counter right here and how it interactively measures the words so that you can tell how far you're along. The requirements for this specific demo is between 500 and 750 words for the overview. When we're done with that, we scroll down and we hit save and continue, and we move on down to the next tab. This is the author tab. On the author tab, we have ourselves listed as Joe Tester. That's the user I'm logged in as. And we can add other authors to this abstract. So I'm just going to enter in some test person that I actually know is in the system, and this way we can see what the system does when there is a duplicate member in the system. If there's no duplicate member, it just goes right ahead and adds the user. So I click add and it says I've entered an invalid email address. So I've got two periods in there, that's why. So it checks for valid email addresses. If you can type properly, you can get your email in the system. So it finds that the address is in the system, and I can add that author, or I can say, no, the information is correct as I entered it. Go ahead and create the new author. So I'm just going to enter the new author, and that adds that person into the system as I entered it. I have the ability to order the authors on the page, so I could put Bob first and Joe second. I'll put it back to have Bob second. When we're done with the adding authors, we just click save and continue, and we go to the attachments page, and here we have the ability to add an image, add a curriculum vitae, or add a table. I'm just going to go through real quickly and show you what it looks like to add a table here. And we're going to put in, get my fingers correct on the keyboard, we're going to put in a title here, and we're just going to save this page some simple information just for demonstration. And we're presented with the disclosure tab. The disclosure section is a little bit more complicated, and we're going to save that for a separate video. And we're going to click on the submit tab, jump to the end, and on this page we're presented with a summary of the entire application process. We can see we've got the title, and we see that there's an error for the title. We don't have enough words, so we cannot submit until we go back and straighten that out. The author section is complete, and you can see we added the primary author and the secondary author. And we see we added no images or CV, but we did add a table. The table is entered there, and there's the title that I put in there for the test title. We have a summary of the disclosures, whether they've been filled out, they're complete or incomplete. We see for the new author, we see that we have an incomplete disclosure, but the primary author's disclosure is complete. So when we've corrected all the errors in this page, we can submit it to the organization. Or we can go back, we can simply save it and wait until we're done with all the information we need to find later. And I just wanted to go back and show you what it looks like to see all the different submissions in the system. There's also a little quick view here, so you can take a quick glance and see what information is missing from each of these different submissions. And you can either withdraw it or go back in and fix the item that's missing. So that is the abstract collection system from AAG.